we'll be seeing like how to load data in Spotify. So this is your log, like a Spotify login. So here, like whenever you do it first time, so this will be installed in your machine. So this will be installed in your machine. So whenever you will join a project, so initially all the three things will be empty here. So what do you have to do first thing? You have to add a server. So since it is an analyst, this is a Spotify analyst, so it needs a server for its existence. Okay? You cannot work without like a server on this. You can work offline, this option. But this option will be enabled only if you are able to connect to your server at least once. Okay? This is like, see this. So first thing is server. So here you have the server. The server will be added from here. Just click on manage servers. Then you have to say add, and then you have to add the server. Okay, and that server should be up and running. Then only it will be connected or it will be added. Let's say I'll put something else. That will give me error that whatever you are trying to add, it's not a relevant server, or the server is not up or running. So this is a kind of error you will get. Okay. So whenever you will be working your project, so you should be like able to connect to your network so that you can just add the server. So this is my server, localhost and all. Okay. And then you have to give your username. So your username will be given, username and passwords. Username and password will be given to you by your administrator. Okay. If you are using single sign-on, then you don't need to give your username and password. So will not be required, username and password. So I believe you understand like the single sign-on. Single sign-on is nothing but as soon as you log into your machine, the credentials what you are using to log into your machine, only those credentials will be automatically will be used for all the applications across your like organization. So whatever like application you're using, automatically you will be all logged into that. Okay, username and password. Save my information. You already know this thing, so this will remember your username and password, so that you don't need to like feed the username and password again and again. As soon as you click on that, it will open this window itself. If you are able to connect to your server at least once, then this work offline option will be enabled. Otherwise, this will be grayed out. Okay. This will be grayed out. Then you have login. You know the thing and cancel. Okay, cancel. Just if you want to cancel this window. Okay. Help is there. If you want to see like anywhere, anytime you feel that you're not working, like whenever you are working alone, this help option is a kind of user document, user manual. It will be opening that particular instance. Wherever you click on this, that instance will be opened here.
Okay.
So this will be like opening like only that particular page. Here you can see that all other options and everything, like everything will be available. It's like A to Z features of like the user manual. Okay. But wherever you click on help, only that information will be shown. But you can navigate to other places also. It's completely user manual itself. There's nothing this. Okay. So just close this. So this is your login. So when you log in, as of now, like my service is not working. So I'll check on this. So when you say login, you'll be able to log into your Spotify instance. As of now, I'm working offline. So this way, you'll be able to log into your Spotify environment. So as we have discussed, Spotify is an in-memory analytical tool. Remember this thing. Spotify is an in-memory and data analytical tool. So we come across two terms here. One is in-memory, another will be in database. Okay. Same thing. Another will be in-memory and another will be in database analysis. So there are two terms which will be like working, and you, people may ask you that what is in-memory, what is a database, and why do we use in-memory when we have in database, or why do we use in database when we can work on in-memory. So these are the questions which you will get definitely.
Okay.
So this is your welcome screen which I showed yesterday. So here we have four tabs: recent analysis, recent data, add data, and samples. All these things are available here itself. But just for your like ease, just for your convenience, they have added these things on the center screen. Okay. Recent analysis means any of the analysis which you have recently opened or worked on. The way in .NET you have recent projects on your like file on your left. You just click on that Visual Studio. You will get recent projects. Same thing here. Recent data that like. You have like recent data files which you have recently worked on. Add data is an option which from where you can load the data. Then you have samples. Samples you can see it, but not required for us.
Okay. No. I have one question, Uri. Actually, yesterday I was going through one article. There it was like it was showing something called Software DXP. What is it actually like? Is it an advanced
No, I'll come across that. Come on. So this is like in-memory in database. Okay, this is fine. So we'll discuss this in-memory. We'll discuss what is in database and all that. Now, whenever you save any of the files, Spotify files, that is saved in the extension of DXP. You call it Spotify DXP or DXP. The way you have XLS. XLSX.pdf, .doc, okay? So these documentations are there. These are like extensions, okay, of the particular document. Same thing for Spotify, you have DXP. I'll save a file, sales analysis. If I save this file in my local machine, then it will be saved as like this.
Okay.
Sales analysis or DXP. So DXP is the extension of Spotify file. Remember this thing.
Okay.
But you will get this extension only if it is saved in your local machine. If it is saved in library, then it won't. Then it won't show you the extension because it is already saved in the library. But when it is saved in the local file, local machine means in your machine or your network machine, then only it will show you the extension. So DXP is the extension of Spotify analysis file. Okay. DXP, there is no such full form of this thing, but people call it as data experience. Like this. Okay. So this is DXP. So this is the extension of Spotify analysis. By the way, you have XLX. So like this, like different in like extensions you might have seen. Same thing for Spotify, you have DXP. Okay. Now, how to load the data? To load the data here, you can connect to any kind of data sources. Okay. You connect to any kind of data sources. You can connect to flat files, Excel files, like CSVs. Web services, databases, SQL Server, Oracle, and all. In my case, like I have SQL Server installed. So recent data, now this says add data. Same options you can see it here itself. Open file. First option what you see here is open files. Open file means any of the files which is saved in your local machine or on your network machine. Okay? Okay. Any of the files which are saved in your local machine or on your network machine. So here you can see files of type DXP, SBDF, TXT, text file, XLX, CSV, etc. First thing is DXP. DXP means Spotify analysis file which you have in your local machine. Let's suppose like today I started working on some like analysis, okay, some like Spotify requirement. Where I downloaded some data, into Spotify, and I created few things, calculations and all that. What I did, instead of saving that document into library, I saved it in my local machine itself, means in my C drive, D drive, or desktop, anywhere. Okay. Yeah. Then next time I'll open, I can directly click on that wherever I have saved that file. Just click on this file. Or I'll open the same this Windows screen like welcome screen, and from here I can open that particular file. Okay, this is like the way you do Excel files or like the Word document you are creating, some PowerPoint or anything. Okay, so you just open it from here or just open a new PowerPoint instance, and from there itself you can say open file. Okay, so this is DXP. SBDF is Spotify binary data format. If you have saved any of the data file as SBDF binary format, then you can open it like this. XLX CSV is already here. You can see all the extensions. So all supported files. These are the all supported files. DXP, XLX, XLX, XLXM, CSV, text, SBDF, Spotify, text, data format. MDB, MDE, SAS files, UDL, SFS, log, SBDF, SSV. .SSV is shape files, mapping files. Okay, so here you can see the full like names of that also. In this you have all the short extensions. These are all complete names. So Microsoft Access Database, SAS files, Universal Data Link, SFS, Spotify server log files, TIBCO Spotify binary data format, ESRI, SRI shape files. This is for mapping charts. So let's say I just want to load this particular table. So just click on that particular CSV, XLX, whatever, and say open. When you say open, like it will load the data. I have unchecked this thing just to show you one thing, that how much time it takes to load the data. So here you see, I'm getting a screen here. And you know, in Excel files, we have multiple sheets. Sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4, like that. Same thing here you have. Three sheets are there. Now Spotify is asking you that which sheet you want to load. I have orders, returns and users. This is for orders data where I have these many columns, these many records. Under returns, I have this many records. Under users, I have this many records. Okay. So in my case, let's say I will load only orders. Yes, I'll load orders. Okay. If there are any empty records, then I will uncheck them. Uncheck them means like I will exclude them. I don't want to load them. So ignore empty rows. Then you have this data. You can just extend it if you want to just see it bigger. Okay. So these are the columns what I have here in this data table. Row ID, order priority, discount, unit price, shipping cost, customer ID, customer name, ship mode and all. So these are the columns. Then you have, these are data types. The next thing what you see here is data types. So let's suppose sometime what happens that it is coming as integer, but you want to keep this as a string, isn't it? So you might have seen this thing like in databases and all that, sometimes say your data is as integer, it's coming as string, or you need to make it as string. You need to change the data types. So you can do it
Yes.
from here itself. Okay. So for every of the column, you can change the data types. You want to change the names? Sometimes like some name is there, you want to rename it. Let's say you can just double click here and you can change it here. Let's say I want to change it to per unit price. Now this will be called as per unit price. Earlier it was unit price, now it will be called as per unit price. So you can do this here itself or after loading the data also. After loading the data, you can't change the data that easily, but you can change the names and all. You can change the data types also, but for that you will do some other operations. So this is your column name data type, and you have these check boxes. And you know this thing like in data table, when we work with the data, there are a lot of things relevant and relevant information there. Here I am having 24 columns. Or let's suppose you are getting 100 columns from a table. You may be aware of this thing that most of the times, 100 columns will not be useful. There will be few columns which are irrelevant according to a requirement. So if you are sure that this column or particular columns will not be required for me in this kind of requirement, then you can uncheck them. So uncheck the check boxes, those columns will not be loaded into Spotify. So this is one of the performance optimization techniques. This is one thing what people will ask you, what all the methods you have applied for performance optimization. The first one is load only required data. Data and columns means records and columns, rows and columns. Yeah, I understand this thing that, but when you start the requirements and all that, you may not be aware that what is required, what is not required. Yeah, this is perfect. But after doing the analysis, after creating this analysis, you can easily identify that what all information is required, what all is not required. You might have loaded a table which is having 100, 200 columns, but after completing the analysis or completing the report, you realize that, okay, let me check what all columns are like used or not used. So after doing this, like you can spend some time on that, and there is no other way than to check manually that which columns are required and not or used or not used. So this way we can remove or like exclude the columns which are not used anywhere in the analysis, anywhere in the report. So what this will help us, this will help Spotify to reduce the size first of all. Okay, reduce the size of the file, analysis file or DXP, whatever you want to call it. Also the performance will also increase. Okay, this is just a sample data. That's where you are seeing just 9,000, 10,000, 20,000 records. Okay, but in real time, we'll be working on 1 million records, 10 million records, 100 million records. Okay, let's suppose this column is there, the row ID. I don't need this. The row ID is nothing but it's a row ID given to each row. Okay, I don't need this. So if I, and this table is having 1 million records. So you can imagine that if I remove this thing, that 1 million cells will be reduced from my data. Isn't it? 1 million cells will be reduced from my data. So this way, at least there will be significant data reduction, like data size reduction in my analysis. Okay. So this is one thing which you have to always remember. Yes, any question?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. So this way, like you can see the data here. On your left hand side, you have another like drop down which tells you about four things here. One is ignore. Whether you want to ignore this particular row, sometimes what happens, you copy the data from a text file or Excel file, random data, and it's not coming like in the right shape or something. You can just ignore that particular row. So this way, this row will be ignored. Sometimes like you have Excel file where you have data as you specifically provide that this is column name, this is data type, this is formula and all that. So you can tell Spotify that this is a name row. Name row means the column names. Type row, data types, data row, it's a data row. Is it fine? Four things. Ignore. Name row means column names. Type row means data type. And data row means the normal data. It's a data. Again.
One question, Adi. For example, yes. If we ignored one row, okay, mm-hmm. What if we get it back? Do we have to do the entire process, or is there a way, you can? Is there an option that you can do it here itself? Get back
no,
the row.
No, you can't do it here. So you have to refresh the data, and then you will get this option again, this screen again. There you can just make it as data row.
Okay.
I'll show you. Let's say I have ignored this.
Showing ignore.
Yeah, yeah. I'll make it as ignore. And this is 18606. Okay, we'll remember this thing.
Okay.
Providing 18606. Now, as I told you, help option is available everywhere. So wherever you go, you might have seen a Vodafone or Hutch advertisement. There is a work dog in that, wherever you go, it follows. Same thing, help is there. So wherever you go, whatever you do, help will always follow you. So right now we are loading an Excel file. So just click on help. It will help you to understand opening an Excel file.
Okay.
Now say okay. It's now loading the data into Spotify. So here it is configuring document, reading data from data source, reading data, configuring document. And then it will show you that where it is loaded. So here you see 7:55:51 it started, 7:55:58 it ended. And I have unchecked this option just to show you that how much time it took to load the data. So it took 7 seconds to load the data. So there is no other way that you can see that how much time it is taking to load the data to opening a report. Make sure if you want to check, then uncheck this option. Otherwise, this screen will close automatically. Close when finished. Next time, it just won't show you this much. Say close, and your data is loaded into Spotify. So this is the data what you have loaded. There are, and see the status bar at the bottom of the page. 9425 of 9425, 0 mark, 24 columns. What it tells us that this data table, whatever you have loaded, this is having 9,425 records, 24 columns. Okay?
So
this is the data loaded into Spotify. X of Y. This is, first one is X and of Y. X will change, Y will never change. Remember this thing. X is the filtered records. Y is the total number of records. This is my filters. Just click on this funnel icon. If I filter some data, here you see 8805. What it is changed? X value is changed, of Y is not changed. Y is still 9425. So remember, for the first number where what we are seeing, this is the filtered records. Second is the total records. Zero mark means nothing is marked till now. Marking means selection, any selections you did.
Adi, sorry to interrupt you. Whatever you're talking in the image is like little delay, I didn't see that X and Y, what you're talking about.
Okay.
A little, can you?
Yeah, I'll do it again. So here you see X of Y. So here, what you're getting, this is 8805 of 9425. Okay. 8805 means the first one is your filtered records. I have applied some filter. Whenever I apply some filter, the first value will change. You getting this?
Okay.
5157 of 9425. So you start applying any filters, the first value will change. But the second value will not change. This tells you that this much was the total number of records, 9425, and this is my filtered records after applying whatever filters I have applied here. Okay? 24 columns are there. Marking is nothing but whatever selection you are doing in your Spotify, be it table, line chart, bar chart, anything, any selection, whatever you are doing, that will be your marking. marking is nothing but just to inform the user that this is what you have selected, this is what you have marked. Okay, so seven records are marked. Okay, seven records are marked. Okay, this is just about the status bar. Now we want to get the data back which we have ignored. So what we'll be doing, you just go to edit, data table properties, we'll say refresh data, we'll say with prompt.
Okay,
you're getting this?
Okay, yeah,
with prompt. When I say with prompt, I will get the same screen again. Can you see? Ignore is there.
Yes,
I'll remove
yes.
it to, I'll change it to data row.
Okay.
Say okay. It is refreshing the data. Now, how many records are there? You can check the total data records.
Yes, it is
9, 2, 6. Yeah, 2, 6, okay. Earlier it was 2, 5, now it is 2, 6. So this way we can exclude or include any of the data. Okay, earlier I was having unit, I have changed like unit price. Okay, now I want to change the name of this column. So that all I can do here itself in the properties. I want to see unit price. I want to change the column name. So I can just change it here. Unit price, say apply. Okay, so yeah, now column name is changed to unit per unit price. But remember, we'll discuss this thing like in the coming sessions. Here you have, this is the display name, but external name is still unit price. So this is the original name. So we'll discuss all that stuff. So this is how you have.
File will be changed, right? Whatever we're changing here, it reflects only in the report that we are doing.
Yeah, it reflects only in the report. Yeah, remember this thing again. One more thing, that whatever changes you are doing in Spotify, it stays here itself. No change, no impact will be done at the data source level, be it Excel file or database. Okay, no change will be done there. Whatever you are doing, everything stays here itself.
Okay.
Okay. So these are your filters. So in Spotify, there are three main things. First is data. Second is relations. Third one is filters. So complete reporting is depends on only on these three items here. Data, visualizations, filters. Load the data, create visualizations. Visualizations means everything. All the dynamic related activities, all the charts, everything. And then apply the filters to get your relevant information. Okay? So first is data, what we have just loaded. Okay? Second one is visualizations. Now this is table. Table is also a visualization. For me, whenever I load the data, I will see the table as the default visualization. For you, when you download the desktop version, it will be bar chart. So how to change it? So it's all up to you. There is no need to change it, but when I see the data table, I can easily see the information that how it is coming or it is coming or not in the right shape. I can create it, but for you, let's say it is coming as bar chart, then go to options. Go to tools, options, document, initial visualization when loading data. Okay, change it to anything the way you like. It's all up to your requirement, your wish, your likings. Okay. So now you want to create any new visualization, anything new, just click on these icons over here. So these are all from here. This table to this, all these are visualizations.
Okay.
This is just for your convenience. They have given it here. Otherwise, it's available under insert. visualization, and all that is available here. These are the short keys. If you want to remember them, you can remember them. You can directly say Control 3, you will get a bar chart. Or just click it here, you will get a bar chart. In a page, we can add any number of visualizations. There is no limit. In a page, we can create any number of visualizations. There is no limit. But normally, we don't create more than 4 to 5. Because as you can see, if I'm creating more and more visualizations, then it is occupying the same space.
Okay.
It is occupying the same space. So now if I keep adding more and more visualizations, what it will do, it will like adjust in the same screen, same size. So what will happen? Other visualization will have lesser space, lesser size. Okay. Now 4 visualizations looks good here.
Now, like we are doing this a chart, right? Like, is it directly taking like what on what basis? Like, you know, here in the pie chart, it's showing sum versus this order priority. Yeah. Will it take it on itself, or do we have to specify explicitly?
No. Right now, whatever you are creating, it is automatically taking that. Okay, it automatically takes some information automatically. There is nothing, it is predefined. Okay, so you don't have to do anything right now. So what I create, so remember, any visualization which you create needs some x-axis, needs some y-axis, needs some color bar, need all that. Okay, it will take automatically by itself. Okay, so let's say here you see that pie chart is there, and here you have the bar chart. Okay. Pie chart is showing you color by as order priority, sector size by discount. But I don't need discount. My requirement is not for discount. My requirement is to have the sales. So what I'll do, I will change it to sales. I have all these columns here, or I can search the column here.
Okay.
Now, or I don't need again color by order priority. I need this by region. So I can search it here again. Region this way. So whenever you create a visualization, it will automatically come with some selections, some axes, but you have to change it according to your requirement. On your bar chart, if you can see, on my y-axis I have row count, but I don't want row count. I need to have the profit. So let's say sales, whatever you want. Order priority, I don't need like order priority, I need category, subcategory. Okay.
Oh, we'll take it based on a requirement from the drop-down.
Yes. Whenever you create a visualization, it will pre-populate with some information. But you have to change it according to your requirement. Color by. Now I want to change it to product category. So now you can see this. So this is your visualizations. Now let's suppose I'll give this name as, just double click on the page name. So you will keep adding multiple pages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and all that. Just click on this plus icon. You can keep adding multiple pages in this. So this is completely called as one report or one dashboard. You create n number of pages in this, it doesn't matter. But combined, it will called as one report. Let's suppose I'll name it as sales analysis. You have to always give some relevant name to pages. Otherwise, like how your user will understand it, what you're doing in this. Okay, so I have given the name as sales analysis. You can drag your visualizations here and there, wherever you want to replace them or to wherever you want. Okay, just bring your cursor. And right now I'm using laptop. So your left key, touchpad, and just drag and drop. You can do it easily using mouse. Okay. Also, it's not required that you have to select the columns from here itself like that. You can drag and drop the columns from filter panel itself. Yes, so I have shift mode. Just drag it on and drag and drop it on color bar. Getting this?
Okay.
I have sales, I have profit and all these things. I need to drop profit here. This is my profit. Do you see? So whenever I bring my drag and drop, if I bring my bring it to the screen, middle of the screen of the visualization, I'll have, this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis. If I can drop it here itself, I don't need to go till here. I can drop here itself. This is my y-axis, this is my color bar, this is my sales, trellis. So this is all I can do here itself. I can drop it here. Okay, so this way,
yes.
You can drag and drop operation. You can do the drag and drop operations also. It's all up to your wish how you want to proceed.
Okay.
Now I want to save this analysis. Today I'm showing you local. Tomorrow when I'll just check my server and I'll restart, reconfigure the server, then I'll show you library, the real environment. So now you have to save this analysis file. Let's suppose this was your requirement, but let's say, let's bring some labels and all. I'll do this thing like from start. This is just to show you your labels and all. Formatting, my users comes from US, so I need to show it everything in USD. Okay?
Okay.
So this is USD. So here you see that I'm having sales versus product subcategory. This is showing me how much sales I'm getting from every region. So this way, like, it's quite relevant information. So my user wants to see this. Okay, this is fine. Now I want to save this. You have this option like save. You just click on that. It will say allow you to save, or you can just go to file, say save as normal document, the way you save normal document, Word, Excel, CSV, anything. You do save as file. So right now when you say save as file and library, so two options you will get in real time also. So one will be file. File means local machine. Library item means your library. Okay.
Okay.
So when you say file, library is Spotify library, the repository where all the report dashboards are saved. In desktop also you will get, right now they are giving you cloud instance. Okay, what Spotify is giving you when you download a desktop version, that will be the cloud instance. So spotify.cloud.com is the server name, and when you connect on that, you will get a library. So you will get access to library also. It will be like actual library, but that is a cloud instance. So whatever you save, whatever you get, that will be on public cloud. You just download that. More I'll show you that how to log in and
okay.
So now
do you want
to say,
download the file version?
Yeah, that is the only option you have.
Okay.
Yeah. Only trial version like you can download.
Okay, I'll do that today.
Yeah. So now I want to save this, say okay. And I'll save it in my desktop, let's say. And give some name here. Sales report. Okay, it will be saved as a Spotify analysis file .dxp.
Okay,
save it, and this name will be saved as sales report. Here you can see it is coming as sales report .dxp. Since it is saved in my local machine or my network machine, that's all your choice, the way you want. Okay. You don't want to keep it in your local machine while you are working like in your office. Okay, you can make it as a network machine also. So you can save it in your some like local, you know, this thing, shared drives and all. So you can save it there. Oh, let's say today, like we stop it here. Okay, today we stop here. I was showing you the same thing, and I'll close this. Okay. So tomorrow I log into the same screen the way I was showing you initially. Now I want to continue working on that. That was not complete what I was doing yesterday, let's suppose. I need to continue working on that. So what I'll do, I'll say open file. I'll go to my place where I have saved that particular analysis file. I'll just click on that sales report here. You can directly click on that also. It's not a requirement that you have to do this way only. You can just click on that. It will open the same screen, same thing. But this is just a way of like one of the way. I was showing you the option. So just click on that. Same report will open. You directly open or open it through file option like this. It's the same thing. Here we are. Now we can continue working on this. Okay. So this is your sales analysis report. But when you save any of the document in your local machine, it means that on this only you can access that. Okay. Obviously, okay. Your machine, your laptop, only no one can access that. It is all up to you. You don't want to share that report till with any of your team members or any of the users till that it is completed. Till it is completed. Okay. So obviously, you will keep it in your local machine only. But let's suppose you are working on something important. And let's suppose this is some important analysis and all that you are doing, and it is in your local machine, local laptop. Now, you are not going to office for next 2-3 days, okay? Because of some like work or you like fell sick or something, okay? Now what will happen? It was an important deliverable, okay? Now, since it is saved in your local file, now no one can access it. No one can access it. Now all the work is stopped. You can't like even save it in your local file or anything. So in your library share drive or anything. Now any of your team member may not like be able to work on that. Or if you want to start something, let's say urgent, then they have to rework everything. And I believe like, let's suppose like you might have spent 2-3 hours to create at least this thing. Okay, loading the data, making the right shape and this. You took 2-3 hours. And isn't it like your team members will have to spend the same time again? Okay. So this is one thing like what people might face. So it is advisable or recommended that you save everything in your Spotify library. Save as library item, which I'll show you tomorrow. Library.
Okay.
In this case, what happens? It is saved in Spotify library is a repository where you save all your work. Okay. So even if you are not there, others team members who have access to the particular folder can open that report and work on that. But okay. It is not like it's like a rule that you have to save there itself. It is just one of the way. If you are sure that you don't want to share your like work till the time it is completed, obviously you will not save it in library. I also do the same thing. I'm working on my own till the time. I don't want to make it like public, or I don't want to make it like with my team members or like with any of the users. I make it in my local machine because I am working on that. I need to work on that particular thing requirement. I'll complete it, then only I will save it in the library. Okay?
Okay.
So this is all up to your requirement. This is just a scenarios where you might face or you may not face. Okay, this is just scenarios based things.
Okay.
Now, we were talking about like data visualization filters. I loaded one Excel file. Now you realize that your requirements cannot be fulfilled by just by using this particular table. You need to load another tables also. So in real time, we may have to work only on one table, or we might have to load multiple tables. Okay, so how to load next table? If I say file and open, what it will do, it will close the existing instance, existing data, and it will open the new one. What it is doing, if you remember, I used an option called open file only last time, isn't it? When I loaded this data table, I used open file.
Yes.
So remember, that will work for the first time. But for the second time, if you do this thing, open here, then the existing will be closed and the new one will be opened. But I don't want to close the existing one. I want to load the next file in the same report itself. So what I'll do, I'll go to file. I will say add data tables now. When
okay.
I say add data tables, here I'll get add option. Then I'll see all other options here. Now I can select the file. File means local machine, local file, anything. Okay.
Okay.
I can say like the clipboard is nothing but whatever you have copied in your controls. So let's say I have copied this thing. If I say okay and say clipboard, then everything whatever I have copied, everything will be saved, copied as a tabular format. So it is clipboard.
Okay.
And you have databases. You have Amazon Redshift, ATBS, SQL Information, Google Analytics, SQL Server, and all that. Let's suppose I want to load the data from SQL Server. So what do you do? Just add data tables to the SQL Server, give your server name, authentication, SQL Server authentication or Windows authentication. I'll take SQL Server authentication. I will use my username and password. I'll check whether this is correct or not. So these things you can get it from your DBA.
Okay.
Database person. Or if you are only working on that, then you can easily have this thing.
Okay.
It is connected. It is showing me these many databases. So out of that, I want to connect to this particular database. AdventureWorks or SolidWorks. So say okay. So right now we are connected to SQL Server database. So this is all the view, like you must be familiar with this thing. So here we have like all the schemas, all the tables, everything, store procedure, anything, whatever you want to have, all that you will be having it here. So these are the SPs and these are all tables. Let's suppose I want to load any of the table, let's say department. Okay, say add. So these are the columns in this particular table called department. Department ID is the primary key. That's what is showing up here. Now,
okay.
You want to load any other table, say employee. So these are the employee table, columns and everything. But I don't think like there is some like an relationship between department and employee. So if you want to create a relationship, this means the joining and all, then relations are there. Okay, we see all this thing. Relations are there so that you can join the tables. As of now, it's not there, so I'll just remove this. I'll keep the employee only. Then I have custom query, something called custom query. Custom query is nothing but like where you can write your own query, your own conditions and all that. So right now, what if you do, if you, I say okay, then it is like select star from employee. Right now, it is select star from employee. Okay, but if I say custom query, then I can write my own query, give the name of the query here, whatever you want to give, and you can write select star from employee where this condition XYZ and all. You can put any conditions there. It's the way you write in your SQL Server, same thing you can write it here itself. Verify it if you want to write something, verify it.
Okay.
Okay. Then you have input parameters and parameters here to like give the way you give the store procedure inputs and outputs. Same thing, you can give the input parameter to load the data based on the input value. Right now, I'm just loading the data as it is. Say OK. Right now, we are into SQL Server. Just click on Help. Details on view connection. It will tell you what all information is there. Okay, everything it will be showing you. So say OK. Now the connection is created, connection, which is a SQL Server. Table name is employee, and we have, you can just give this name as employee data. Okay. Okay. It's loading, it's loaded. So what it did, it created a new page for this data. This is SQL Server data, employee data. Here you see external data, employee data. Can you see the difference?
Okay.
Here I'm getting what information I'm getting?
Yeah, sample.
What difference you are seeing?
This is like the sales analysis.
No. Let's say I have two tables, both the tables here. Right now I'm into sales analysis. What difference you are seeing? Right now I'm into employee data. What you are getting? Can you notice something?
It it is showing external data here.
Now,
it's not showing anything in the sales now.
See, Excel files, I'll remove everything here. Excel, CSV. Now read this thing. Excel CSVs, information links, web services, data, whatever you're trying to load into Spotfire, all that will be in-memory analysis. Direct connection to databases will always be in database analysis. Getting this? Okay, I'll explain. Here I have loaded an Excel file. Because of that, the complete data of Excel file gets loaded into Spotfire, inside Spotfire memory. Okay, whatever data you have, be it 1000 record or 1 million records, complete data will be loaded into Spotfire memory and you will see the number of records, number of columns, everything. Okay?
Yeah, okay.
This means you are working in memory analysis. This will work for Excel, CSV, text files, okay, information links, which is one of the most important topic in Spotfire, web services, all that is in memory analysis, okay? But this is direct connection to database. What I did, I used an option called direct connection, okay? Direct connection to SQL Server database. Because of that, it doesn't tell me that how many tables, how many records are there, how many columns are there, since it is external. Here, the complete data is loaded into Spotfire memory. Here, I'm just getting a view of Spotfire. Okay? It's like here some guest is coming to your home, okay? And you are talking like face to face, okay? And this is your like a Skype call or let's say WhatsApp video call. You getting this? Okay, here it is your face-to-face interview, here it is your Skype interview. Just get this thing like this. Okay, so what is happening here, the complete data is loaded into Spotfire memory. Now, whatever calculations, whatever aggregations, what all you do here, everything will happen in Spotfire only. Okay? But in case of in-database analysis, the data, whatever data we eat, okay? Whatever data, right now this is less than 10,000 records, less than 10,000 records. That's it, these are full data, full records, all the records are loaded. In this analysis, in this case, only 10,000 records, okay, are shown in Spotfire. Remember this.
Okay.
While you create indirect in-database connections, only 10,000 records are shown in Spotfire. Even though it is having more than 1 million, 10 million, 100 million, whatever, only 10,000 will be shown in Spotfire. So it's like, get this thing again, in memory means complete data will be loaded into Spotfire memory. Okay, in database connection, you just see the partial data, a partial subset of data. In this case, in memory analysis, whatever calculations, aggregations you will do, everything will happen in Spotify. Here in this case, any aggregation calculation will happen in database, and then final result will be shown in Spotify. You getting this?
Okay, I got it.
So that's the difference between in memory and in database. A question will arise, what's the use of this thing? See, when you say in memory, you get high performance, good performance, because whatever calculations, aggregations you are doing, all that is happening in Spotify, you are utilizing the memory of Spotify. But in case of in database analysis, you do some aggregation, you do some calculation. The aggregation, the calculation will go back to database, then it will be done there, and then final result will be showing it up here. Also, when you have in-memory analysis, you can use A to Z features of Spotify. Okay?
Okay.
But when you have in database analysis, you have some limitations. First thing, let me show you. I have a cross table. Cross table kind of pivot table.
Okay.
Here it is created on Sample Superstore. Okay, it's working. Means you are able to see some information here. But if I change it to employee data, okay, here you have and yeah, summary table. Here it is okay, sample data, but when I change it to, here you see, this visualization does not support external data tables. This is for employee data, which is an external data. Also, if I want to do some calculations and all, employee data, first of all, see the superstore data. Here you see the functions, the list of functions, you see?
Yeah.
But when I change it to employee data, it is less. Here you see, it is less than the earlier of here. Isn't it?
Yeah.
So remember, while you are using in database connection, you can only use those functions. You can use only those functions which are supported by your database. Okay? You can use only those functions which are supported by your database. I have binning function, very important function in Spotify, bin. But here you see, it's not coming. Since it is not supported by your database, why it's coming? Let's suppose I'm just taking randomly something. Okay. Could not find function. Why it is saying could not find function? Because here you see the official Microsoft SQL Server documentation for the description of this operator. So only those functions will be supported which are supported by SQL Server, because our database is SQL here. Means I have loaded this data from SQL Server or Oracle or Teradata, whatever. Okay. So only those functions will be supported which are supported by the database. But when it is in memory, I can use each and every function. Here you see. All that is coming. So I can use each and every function because I'm not dependent on database, even though this data will be coming. Let's suppose this employee data is there. Right now I have created an in database connection, direct connection to database where I gave the SQL Server and all. Information link is also the same thing. I will connect it to my database. I will fetch the data from query and then load into Spotify. But implementation is different. That is the difference here in information links. But in case of information link, it will become in memory. Okay. So this is one thing like what you have to understand in memory and in database. So this is very, very important topic like in Spotify before starting the real examples or visualizations and everything to understand about the data. Same thing, you have another option called add data tables. So you have many other options here. It all depends on you, like or your business requirement, that what all databases you have. You may not see a big, this big list in your environment, because your database, your admin might have like limited only one or two databases only. One is called OData. OData is nothing but Open Data Protocol, web services. So using this, you know, OData, OData is a product of Microsoft. So yeah, using this, you can connect to any other services. This is a service URL. Authentication, if you are using some like authenticated like services, in my case, it is a free service. Say connect. This service is somewhere on remote location. Might be in US or Europe somewhere, I don't know. But okay, a URL is there. I want to load customer's data. Say add. So this is the data, what all is loading. It's the same kind of view what we just saw for SQL Server. Only thing here, we can't write the custom query here. Custom query option is disabled here, grayed out. Say okay. Customer's data. So that's a naming. You don't need to do it all the time. It's all your way.
Okay.
Say okay. I have loaded data, and here you see it is customer's data, 91 records. I am able to see 91 of 91 means like the number of records, number of columns, 11 columns and all. It means what kind of data it is? What kind of data it will be considered? In memory or in database?
It's a database.
It will be considered in memory, since I am able to see the number of records. The complete data of this table is loaded into Spot5. That's the reason I am seeing the number of records. Okay, this will be called as in memory.
Okay.
So this is just about a data loading and all. So tomorrow we'll see the like the library and all. Then we'll move to visualization. So we'll go through each and every visualization, their properties and all. So there is one thing you have to remember always, that like no matter how much effort you have put in the coding or in the analysis or in the calculations and all, it doesn't matter. What okay matters is like how best you can present the information for your users, because ultimately users will analyze the things using visualizations, what you are showing them. Okay, they won't like understand that how much effort you put into like getting the right information, right data, right calculation, right code. So your real-time efforts are spent in that, but users don't understand that. Users say, I want to see this data, this visualization and all only. Okay, so the main thing what is depending like our report, the users will like it or not, is all visualizations, how best we can present the information. So that is based on the visualizations only. So for today, I wind up here. Tomorrow you see.
Sure. And the one question, Ali, like, will you give me any kind of material or something like
You can just send me like your email. I'll send you these Excel files. I'll send you a few things for you so that like you can work on these things.
Okay.
Whatever I'm working, so you can also work on the same thing. I'll send you the files, some like information and all.
Okay. Do you want to want me to post my email address?
Yeah, just post it here and I'll send you it.
Okay.
Okay. I got this. I'll send you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Have a good day. Bye.